In this video, first I'll show you how to install Kali Linux in VirtualBox without any errors within 15 to 20 minutes. And then I'll show you how to enable Kali Linux full screen in VirtualBox. I'll also show you how to enable file sharing between Windows and VirtualBox by installing VirtualBox guest editions. So let's begin. First, open up your browser and type Kali Linux download. Click on the first link. You need to download any one of these two images because these are the officially recommended ISO images for offline installation. Click on any one of these two files. Our download is now started. Our download is now complete. Now again go to your browser and type VirtualBox download and hit enter. Click on the first link. Now click on this to download VirtualBox for Windows. I have already downloaded and installed VirtualBox in my computer. Now right click taskbar and click on task manager. Go to performance tab and down here virtualization should have been enabled. If this is disabled, then you have to enable it in your BIOS settings. Now close task manager. Right click VirtualBox and click on run as administrator. Click on yes if prompted. Click on new. Give it a name, Kali Linux. Then select type, Linux. Then select version, Linux 2.6/3.x/4.x. Select 64-bit if you have downloaded 64-bit Kali Linux ISO image. Select 32-bit if you have downloaded 32-bit Kali Linux ISO image. Select appropriate option and click on next. In this box, type half of the total RAM memory available in your computer. For example, in my computer, I have total RAM memory of 8192 MB. So 8192 divided by 2 is equal to 4096. So in my case, it's 4096. In your case, it might be different. You can also manually move the slider to adjust RAM memory, but don't move this into red zone. Keep it within green zone. Then click on next. Select create virtual hard disk now and click on create. Select VDI and click on next. Select dynamically allocated and click on next. In this box, type 55 GB. You need at least 30 to 40 GB and click on create. Click on settings. Go to advanced tab. From this drop down, select bidirectional. Once again, from this drop down, select bidirectional. Then go to system and go to processor tab. Move the slider till green zone. Don't move this into red zone. And if you don't have green zone, then don't move this. Then go to display. Now move the video memory slider to maximum limit. Then from this drop down, select VMS VGA. Click on OK. Now under storage, click on optical drive empty and click on choose a disk file and select the Kali Linux ISO image which you downloaded and click on open. Before starting, close any other application except VirtualBox. Without internet, it took me about 30 minutes for the installation to complete, and with internet, it took me about 3 hours for the installation to complete. In this video, even though I am connected to the internet, I am not going to use it. Click on start. Select graphical install and hit enter. Select your language. Just double click. Double click your location. Double click your keyboard layout. Leave the host name as it is and click on continue. No need to change the domain name, just leave this blank and click on continue. Now type in a username and make sure you remember this because you need this when you log in Kali Linux. Then click on continue. Click on continue again. Type in a strong password. Type it again and make sure these two match and click on continue. Select guided use entire disk and click on continue. Select ATA VBox hard disk and click on continue. Select separate home partition and click on continue. Click on finish partitioning and write changes to disk and click on continue. Select yes and click on continue. This is very important part in this whole video. If you do this step wrong, then it will take 3 to 4 hours to complete, and sometimes even after 3 to 4 hours you will only get installation failed error message. So please be careful. When you are in this step, configure the package manager. Just click on go back. Continue without a network mirror. Select yes and click on continue. No need to change anything. Just click on continue. Down here you can see the time taken for installation. It took me about 12 minutes for this particular step to complete. Install the grub bootloader to master boot record. Select yes and click on continue. Then select /dev/sda and click on continue. Our installation is now complete. Click on continue. Now VirtualBox will automatically restart. Type your username and your password which you created earlier and hit enter. Go to start menu and type display. Click on display. Now we will change the resolution so that we can see things clearly. From this drop down, select 1280x800 and click on apply. Then click on close. Again go to start menu and open the web browser. Click on documentation. Scroll down and click on general use. Now again scroll down and click on updating Kali. Scroll down. Select and copy these two lines. Just copy it. Now close the browser. Open up a terminal by clicking on this. Let me adjust this. Now type echo space pipe symbol space sudo space t space /etc/apt/sources.list and hit enter. Type in your password and hit enter. Then type sudo space nano space /etc/apt/sources.list and hit enter. Now you will see something like this. Just right click over here and paste the copied text. Now press CTRL+S and then press CTRL+X. Then type sudo space apt space update and hit enter. This will download some files. Now type sudo space apt space install space linux hyphen image hyphen amd64 if you have installed 64-bit Kali Linux, or type 686 if you have installed 32-bit Kali Linux. I have installed 64-bit Kali Linux, so I am going to type amd64 and hit enter. Now type y and hit enter. Once again this will download the appropriate file. Now close the terminal and restart your VirtualBox. type your username and password and login. Again, open up your terminal and type sudo space apt space install space hyphen y space linux hyphen headers hyphen dollar symbol open parentheses uname space hyphen r close parentheses and hit enter. Type in your password and hit enter. Now close the terminal. Go to devices and click on insert guest edition cdmatch. Now go inside this. Select all the files present inside and copy it. Right click desktop and click on create folder. Name it VBox and click on create. Now go inside the VBox folder and paste the copied files. Now right click inside this folder and click on open terminal here. Type ls and hit enter. You will see a list like this. Then type sudo space chmod space 777 space. Now select and copy exactly this file name. Just copy it and paste it over here and hit enter. Type in your password and hit enter. Now type sudo space dot forward slash. Again paste the copied file name exactly and hit enter. Close the terminal and restart VirtualBox and login. It will take some time and it will automatically adjust the resolution. Now maximize the window. And as you can see, Kali Linux full screen is now enabled. To enable file sharing, go to devices, then go to shared folders and click on shared folder settings. Select machine folder and click on this. Click on this drop down and click on other. Select the folder or drive which you want to share and click on select folder. Check auto mount, check make permanent and click on OK. Click on OK again. Once again open terminal. Finally type sudo space add user space dollar symbol user in uppercase space vbox sf and hit enter. Now type your password and hit enter. Now close the terminal and restart your VirtualBox for one final time. Login Kali Linux. Now go inside file system and on the left side you will find the shared folder. You will find your files inside, as you can see. So that's it guys. Thanks for watching. If you find this video helpful, then please do consider subscribing to our channel. Bye.